Away we go with the first set. The Dutchies in orange serving, the Aussies in blue receiving. Good up. It touched the block, so Madeline Nepelink playing it back over. And first point on the board goes to Australia, but they had to work for that side egg. Good dig from Tiliqua, but that also must have caught board, and she plays it back over. Block counts as a touch on the beach, and it's a net touch this time by Borden. Good out. Right into the corner. Nice play from Australia. Borden. Oh, that's a good serve. That rose right at Marlene Van Ersel. Free ball back then for Australia. Chance to go 3-1 up. Tiliqua. Oh, unlucky. Unforced error from her, trying to avoid Madeline Nepelin's block. And the Netherlands get lucky. Great block from Madeline Nepelink. Just what the Netherlands needed to help settle and calm the nerves. Borden couldn't keep it in play. Forced error. Slightly wild serve from Van Ersel. So she does have a really good jump serve on her. One of the toughest on the tour when she gets it going. So at the end switch, it's the Netherlands who are one up, courtesy of that line roll from Van Ersel. Another good block from Madeline Nepelink. That's two for her now. It might come back, oh dear. Well, I hope they're okay. Madeline Nepelink just with eyes on the ball, and Van Ersel almost rugby tackling her. Not intentionally. Is that out of the way, out of the way, out of the way? Oh, maybe not. Always a danger when you're the server and you're having to get to the net. Australia going over on two before Madeline could actually get herself in a good position to make a block. And Australia then with the side out. One behind, Borden with the serve. And Borden with a huge block. That's her first of the match to level things up. Palink hitting in rhythm, and Borden was alive to it. Very nice pokey. Van Aerssel steadies the ship. And the Netherlands stay in front. Van Aerssel with the serve. Great blocking from Madeline Mepelink. Two in a row from her, the first just being the transition one, but she stuck at it and made the kill block with the follow-up. Couldn't put the first one down, but definitely put the second down. Good swing from Borden. She hasn't had a lot to do in that department so far. Most of the serves have gone on to Aliqua Clancy. Good pass from Marlene. And a great chase as well. Net touch against Van Aerssel. That was a shame. Marley not the recognised blocker in the partnership, but had to adjust because the Netherlands were out of position. That's a lovely pickup. Couldn't put the ball away, then had to stay at the net. Wasn't enough time for her to get back, and as she went with the Kong block, touches the top of the net. All square then, and still all to play for. Oh, great serve from Australia. Right down the middle, down that panic channel. And the two teams have played each other four times previously. It's 2-2 in the series. But on the last two occasions, it's been the Netherlands who have won, and that was in Stavanger. First in the pool and then in the knockout stages. They won 2-1 and then 2-0, 22-20, 21-19. So it's been close, and this is proving to be exactly the same here. Great swing from Van Aerssel. Forced error from Taliqua, hands the initiative to the Netherlands. Well, that's a great serve from Madeline Mepelink. That one dropping like a stone once it went over the net. The Aussie's not expecting that. Good play from Borden. Nice play. Well, this is a really important passage of play now for the Netherlands. They've got 11-9. We're one away from the technical timeout. If they can keep this going, then the pressure will just become more and more difficult for Australia. So the technical timeout is still very much all to play for. 1 point separating the teams, but it's the number one seeds, the hosts, the crowd favourites, who have the lead. That's Morf Boes, the head coach for the Netherlands, and that is pretty much his reaction to everything when he's watching. He is as impassive as you can get. Really nice chap. Actually had the pleasure of playing beach volleyball with him domestically in the UK. He's a former England, Scottish and Great Britain international, played professionally in Europe before moving into coaching. He was part of the Great Britain setup for the Olympic Games, and now very much involved with the success that the Netherlands are having. Good up, great chase, but a really good opportunity now to go two ahead, but that was wasted. Madeline Meppeling didn't really have a good angle coming in from that side of the court and then trying to cut the ball across her body. They generated a great opportunity but couldn't finish it off for the Netherlands. Well, that was a really good serve. Borden taking it late. Free ball now for the Netherlands. Oh, it doesn't find the sideline. Well, that's a bit of a worry for Madeline Meppeling. Twice now, the Netherlands have put themselves in a great opportunity and given themselves a chance, but been unable to finish it off. That looked close, didn't it? Looked more in than out. But it's got to hit the line, and it didn't. Nice white this time from Meppeling. Getting the side out, getting the important thing done really, because that's the key, keeping the lead, keeping the pressure on. Van Aerssel. Oh, good reactions by Talikwa. She knew that where the space was, took it away from the sand, and then comes up with a lovely line roll to level the scores. But remember, that was just their side out. They had to work really hard to get it. Psychologically, it's still the Netherlands with the advantage. Right into the corner, right between Van Aerssel and Meppeling. Lovely shot from Clancy. I think there's going to come a time when the rules will say, if you want to wear sunglasses, then that's up to you, but you're not going to have time to clean them other than during timeouts and end of sets, as players are using them almost as an opportunity to slow play down. Well, we were 7-all, we're now 14-all. This, the business end of the first set, and who's going to take it? Meppeling. Side out achieved by Australia. Nice line roll shot. Nice play, Van Aerssel. Just steady volleyball. That's a big point, because it puts them in the lead, and they've done it from defence, putting the ball into transition, and Van Aerssel hammering it down. With the serve, all dear. Well, she's going for it. I had license to do so, really, because it's only a side out for Australia. Clancy. And it'll stay in play. And almost turned into transition by the Netherlands, but it's Australia now who move in front under pressure from the serve, and they really couldn't get on the front foot in the rally. And Australia make their move. Oh, this is a great opportunity now for Australia. 2 points up. And head coach staying impassive, having a little word, but there will be a little bit of panic going on underneath, surely, as the Netherlands are put down by a great block from Borden. Timeout called. Australia in the ascendancy. Some of the action from the super slow-mo captured so far during the match, and just see the sand and the sweat spraying off the players. Captures everything. That's a great shot, isn't it? Seeing the ball like that in their sunglasses. That's pretty cool. Taliqua will serve for Australia. The Netherlands need to side this one out. Oh, Did it catch the block? No, it didn't, and it didn't find its way into court. And now the Australians will feel that they've done enough to take this set. A three-point lead. They only need two more. Van Essel not quite getting the control she wanted. And this set is slipping away from the number one seeds. Good hustle. Nice dig from Mepelink. Needs to put this one away though. And she does. The pokey to the line is good enough. And the Netherlands make side out. But they have to make some points from serve now. They held their nerve here. Can they do it from the serving line? Weak rotation because Madeline Mepelink's serving has to come through to the net to block. It's a decent serve though. It's a great serve. Free ball for the Netherlands. Chance to get back to within one. Mepelink hammers it cross court. They are back to within one. And the pressure has gone back to Australia as they look to side out. Brilliant serve. It had Australia reeling and the free ball dispatched by Mepelink. They're not giving up without a fight. Timeout call by Australia. What are Australia going to do here? I think we know what the Netherlands are going to do. They're probably going to go after Borden again after she made that poor pass. Mepelink just taking a few deep breaths, settling herself. Coach, as ever, he's not asleep, I can assure you. He is watching intently what's going on. Is Morf Bose, the coach for the Netherlands. Mepelink with the serve. Australia looking for side out to get set point. It's a nervy pass off the net here. Chance maybe. The dig is made. Van Essel, can she get it close to the net? Oh, she can. But they can't put it down. Another great dig. Better chance now for the Netherlands. The line roll is on and it's good. And they've levelled at 19-all. Magnificent 2 points for the Netherlands at 17-19 down with serve. You would have backed Australia to get a side out and give themselves set point, but no, the Netherlands refused to let the ball hit the sand, and Van Essel with the line roll has drawn the number one seeds level. Can they do it again? Australia are really, that's too tight, and it's now set point for the Netherlands. Goodness me, what a turnaround. The Australian fans can't believe it. The Australian pairing can't believe it. But you better believe it. Set point now for the Netherlands. Saved set point. So that means it's the first to get two clear. We'll take this set. Well, they managed to get themselves back in. They have the side out, but it's very much advantage the Netherlands here because every time they side out, they have set point. Australia need 2 points from serve to take this one. The Netherlands now only need one. Van Essel for set point number two. Just the continuation, Mepelink. And she's put down with a magnificent block from Borden. And Australia generate their first set point. What a roller coaster set this is. Well, it looked like Australia were going to take it at 19-17, but then the Netherlands bounced back and engineered a set point. But now it's set point for Australia. Saved by Van Essel. goodness me, what a thrilling first set we're witnessing, and it's still not over. Which way is it going to go? Well, it goes to Australia, and the Netherlands can't believe it because they believe that ball was out. But a touch has been called, and it's set point again for Australia. Well, what controversy. It didn't touch her, did it? She caught the hand of Louise Borden. It certainly didn't look like she touched the ball. Did she touch the net? No, she didn't. It's just a collision of players, and no wonder they're furious. Well, it's up to Australia to get a good serving, but it's up to the Netherlands here to try and put that away and just concentrate on getting side out. Madeline Mepelenk is going to feel hard done by Van Aerssel, just trying to cool things down because there's no timeout left for the Netherlands, and a yellow card time delay has been issued. They don't care about that. They're just trying to disrupt the rhythm. They need side out. Clancy with the serve. And she makes side out. She's furious, isn't she? She'll feel desperately hard done by. But we are back on level terms again, and we'll just keep going until somebody gets too clear. Mepelenk with the serve. And Clancy decides to go over on two before Madeline Mepelenk can get to the net. It works. It's another set point now for Australia. They're going to have a swing for the set. Clancy, she's done it, over the block. Australia take the first set, 24-22. What a match we are witnessing here. And I think Madeline Mepelenk's going to find herself in a little bit of trouble here, having a little word to Osvaldo Sumaville. Depends how he handles that. I'll just tell him to calm down. Mepelenk's still furious about that ball that she felt didn't touch her, that was given against her. But that's all irrelevant. It's done, it's consigned to history. Because Clancy made the pickup and then put the ball away, and as a result, Australia take the first set. Wow, time to stop and catch your breath. What a first set that was. Well, here's your first set statistics. What a game. The Netherlands will be telling themselves, look, nothing to worry about, still two more sets to play. We're going to have another look at this controversial issue. You could tell by Madeline Mepelenk's reaction, she was convinced she didn't touch it. Here's the pokey. Did it catch her fingertips? Didn't look like it did. She was convinced it didn't. It was just a coming together of hands, wasn't it? No, it definitely, that shows us it definitely didn't touch her, didn't it? I think the fact that there was the hands come together, the referees have seen something different, but look, they get a split second to make that decision. We've had a good look at it now. There's several different angles to make our decision. Morph Bose, well, he'll just sit and watch. He's given the girls their game plan. He's the head coach. He knows what they're capable of. They know what they're capable of. And then it's all up to them now out on court to make it happen. They certainly can't let that controversial decision affect the match. They have to put that to one side, come out and play. Still two more sets potentially to be played. Australia in the driving seat as we get this second set underway. Leading one set to nothing. Clancy with the serve. Van Aerssel wrapping it off the block. Nice play from her. That one finding the sideline. Netherlands get their side out. Good cut down to that line. That's the sort of thing that the fans want to see. That's what the head coach wants to see. They bounce back, they're straight in. A point from serve, and 2-0. Good covering from Meffelink. Side out achieved. Gordon turning and sending that one down to the line brilliantly. Good block from Borden. The ball in too tight really from Meffelink. Nothing much Van Aerssel could do. So both teams now with a point from serve. It's amazing watching Australia play. I've been watching them throughout the tournament, and those of you who saw them play against Guatemala would have probably been shocked when they lost their first set. And then come out and won. That's a brilliant play from the Netherlands. In fact, it wasn't Guatemala, my apologies, it was against Paraguay. They beat Gabriela Filippo and Michela Valiente. They lost 17-21, and then they went out and won 21-8, 15-1 with Australia. And you kind of got the feeling, yeah, that's how good they are when they want to play, and that's why they're proving to be a difficult customer here against the Netherlands, because they're back up to that form. Good chase. That was unlucky. That's the problem that unfortunately for Borden, she's a lefty, and they almost had to do a 360 to get that one in play. A good hustle from the Netherlands. That's really good reactions from Madeline Meffelink, actually, after being blocked, to turn around and keep the ball off the sand. But this is almost impossible for Borden to know where the court is after making that 360, and that's what the fans thought. All hoping that the Netherlands can get the job done here. They'll have to do it in three sets, though. Good up from Van Aerssel. Can't see again, goes over on two, and she pays the price. And this is just phenomenal from the Netherlands. 6-2, Australia call timeout. This is what the fans were expecting to see in the first set, but credit Australia, they were playing magnificently. And it's now the Netherlands' turn to show who's boss. Well, time for all of us to catch a breather. Meffelink, the deep breath, sets herself, gets ready with the serve. That's the trouble. Again, not serving tough enough on Borden to allow her to put the ball up for Clancy to have a swing, and Meppelink still on her way to the net. So easy side out for Australia. That's a nice cross-court roll from Van Aerssel, putting that one in front of Clancy, but leaving her rooted in the sand. Well, just for a moment there was an opportunity for Meppelink to break from the net, and I think she thought about it and decided not to, and it's cost the Netherlands a chance to get a point from transition because Borden's off the net and she wasn't swinging hard. Good use. Interesting serve from Borden, going all the way back and just trying to hit a flat, low serve. And see if it moves around a little bit. Well dealt with by Van Aerssel, and then a really good use of the block as well. Just aiming high hands, getting the job done. Nice. This time, Meppelink got into the net a little bit quicker, able to get a better touch on the ball as Australia tried to go over on two. Comes sprinting in. Borden again trying to put Clancy in a position to hit, but it wasn't the best of passes to that position. And the Netherlands pounce. Oh, that's a great serve from Madeline Meppelink. And a really good play from Van Aerssel, who goes back over on two, and Australia didn't know what to do with that play. 6-point lead now for the Netherlands. And surely we'll be heading into a decider. Wonder whether or not Meppelink needs to adjust what she's doing. That's just a dolly dropper, trying to roll it short, put it short, but it wasn't served properly. The other option is to put it across Bowden and towards Taliqua, just keep them from being able to play the ball up to go over on two. Good disguise, net touch by Borden anyway, but lovely play from Van Aerssel. They have full control of this set now. Clever play. And Marlene Van Aerssel steps into Laura Ludwig's costume and plays the ball straight back over. That's a trademark of the German international, and copied successfully by Marlene Van Aerssel, going straight back over. Bit of volley, you could see that there was the space to exploit. Another good serve, and that's that ball between the two players across Borden and into Taliqua. They know she's going to go over on two, so he's just saying, okay, well, if you're going to have a spike, let's make you play it so we can get in a position to be able to try and stop you. This time, though, Clancy is able to get the better of Meppelink. Not sure they'll be cleaned or just rub the smudge further around the glasses, really. Either way, he's got a bit of a breather. Borden to serve. Well watched by Meppelink. Well, sometimes when a player shouts at you of what you've got available, instead of being cool and calm about it, it can actually put you off. It looked like that's what happened with Madeline Meppelink. A big screen from Van Aerssel of what she had available. And it's a mishit from Meppelink. Gordon gets to serve again. This time Van Aerssel will look to side out. Good dig. And Van Aerssel has a long look at the scoreboard before deciding timeout not required just yet. They'll try and side out. Too much on the ball. Third serve now for Borden. This time way back by the advertising hoardings. Good up. Ertelique not quick enough to chase after it. And the Netherlands' decision not to call a timeout, a wise one. Because we're now at the technical timeout and a break was inevitable. So the Netherlands have turned things around in their favour here in this second set, and if they win it, we'll head to a decider. Well, very interesting timeout as we have a look at the super slow-mo action. Madeline Meppelink just saying to Van Aerssel that she needs time. She wants to create more time for herself to be able to come and attack the ball. And I think probably as well the serving is an issue. She's not getting that time also to get into the net. Meppelink with the serve. Oh, that's a good one as well. That won't stay in play though. Clancy was having to snatch at that, but such is the height of these two for Borden and Clancy that makes them very difficult to deal with. And even when the ball like that from Borden goes in, Clancy can still get a paw on it. Clancy with the serve. Top side out. Borden looks to the ref. She thinks it might have been out. This one's right onto the line. Great swing. Good serve. Great up from Van Aerssel. But a great block from Clancy, and side out secured by Australia. Much to the delight of the fan. Wasn't rolled high enough, and look how high Clancy gets to swap that one back down. Brilliant. Line block signalled against Van Aerssel. But even with Clancy stood cross-court, she still couldn't play it. And now she shows she should have gone high hands. Cross-court block signalled against Clancy. And it almost worked, didn't it, Van Aerssel? Trying to prowl around the line. This is what Clancy's so good at, even off the net, to generate height and power. Very nicely done. Chipping that one overboard and in front of Clancy, both of them hitting the sand, neither of them keeping the ball off it. Great shot from the Netherlands, well disguised, worthy of a fist pump. Well, it's a real problem, isn't it? It's a bit of a thorn in the Netherlands side at the moment, is Telica going over on two. Which leaves the Netherlands with a decision to make. Do they keep doing what they're doing? Or do they actually go after Telica a little bit? One thing they'll need to do, if they're going to go after Borden, they've got to either bring her in really short or push her really deep. Just make it so that she can't put the ball up and do what she wants to do with it, to give Telica that opportunity to go over on two. And more, as far as that's concerned, about their third set, because it's definitely going that way now. 5 points up, only four required. Good touch from Madeline. Maybe the Netherlands just lulling Australia into a false sense of security about the way that they're playing currently. Now they have this big lead. Let Clancy and Borden think that that's fine. They can keep getting away with it. They may change it up for the third set, though. Oh, great shot from Clancy. Brilliant. Marlene van Aerssel not happy, doesn't believe that was a hard roll, a hard shot, hard driven, says to Elsie Oliveira, come on, you've seen my hard shot. Well, the rules are quite straightforward. If you have if you hit the ball hard and you spike it and you go high hands defense, that's fine, but if you're rolling it or it's off speed, you're not allowed to do that. And van Aerssel wasn't happy that that ball was hard driven. She felt it was just a roll. And that roll is successful. Well, that's twice now. The Netherlands have just let their concentration slip away to stuff that they can't control. It happened in the first set. It's just happened here in the second, but they have a big lead. They need to get refocused here. Particularly Van Aerssel, who was having that chat with the referee. Jump serve to come. And it's a good one as well. Meppelink deciding very late to break from the net and was in no position at all to play the ball. The only players in the world that probably could have played this are Brazilian Juliana and Telita, the world's best at breaking from the net and playing high hands defense. Lovely play from Madeline Meppelink, rolling that one over the block. It was flirting with the wrong side of the sideline, but fortunately landed in play. It took a while. Moff Bowes, the head coach for the girls, watching on impassively as ever. Great pick up from Van Aerssel. Brilliant put away. And it's set point now for the number one seeds. That was world-class defense from Marlene Van Aerssel. Excellent blocking as well. But look at that. That is just superb. So she had the opportunity to swing hard and took it. Well, somehow Clancy gets away with that one. Van Aerssel looked to be in the right place to stop it, but just great speed and height from Clancy. But as far as the Netherlands are concerned now, four opportunities to take this one into the decider. They only have to side out to get it done. And they have got it done. Van Aerssel goes over on two. We're heading into a decider. This is how it was done. Well, here are the statistics from that second set. And, wow, what a match we're seeing. It's now going to be the race to 15. Still have to win by two clear points. Here, then, are the highlights. Players ready for this deciding set. Australia will serve, Netherlands receiving. The winner is through to the quarterfinals of the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Championships here in the Netherlands. And the first point goes the way of Madeline and Marlene. Taking on Clancy and beating her. Good serve, overpassed, put away, 2-0 the Netherlands. That's the first time Marlene Van Ursel has really delivered some heat from the serving line, and it's paid dividends, hasn't it? Easy block for Meppeling. Oh, Marlene with a slightly easier serve, and even with Madeline Meppeling at the net, still can't stop Clancy going over on two. Oh, big block from Borden. It was in tight at the net, and Marlene Van Ursel looked like she turned that back into the block. No, she did indeed, trying to find the line, but it was taken away brilliantly by Louise Borden. Nice cut. Huge support here for the Netherlands, as you'd expect. And Australia not overawed by it all. Oh, goodness me. Oh, it's come off the block. Wow. But it went long. That was not in question. The nearest of touches from Meppeling. And that Louise Borden gets lucky. Very lucky. Good up from Van Ursel. Another good dig from Clancy. That's two now from her in this rally. And off the block and out of play. Australia edge in front. Good high hands shot from Clancy. Signaled touch by the referee. Point for Australia. They have the lead. Serve from Clancy, and that silences the stadium here. Well, you have to give that one. That's a great serve, a 1-in-10 serve. If she hit another 9 of these, it wouldn't happen again. Netherlands need to regroup. Clancy serving again. Thank you. it's an unforced error from Van Aerssel. This is not what the Netherlands wanted. Timeout called, they're three behind. And it all seemed to stem from that block from Louise Borden, didn't it, on Van Aerssel? And it's got in the heads of the number one seeds. Plenty of discussions to be had between the players. Australia wanting to keep their lead, the Netherlands trying to get it back. Head coach for the Netherlands looking on impassively as ever more foes. He knows what his team are capable of. He knows that they can turn this situation around. Just be hoping that they'll go on and do it. Net touch against Borden, who says, I didn't touch it. Referee saying she did. Yeah, well, she did. Well, we've seen Van Aerssel generate an overpass to give the Netherlands a point. She's yet to generate an ace. Now would be a good time to get one. Ooh, well, that was unlucky. Catching the top of the net, could have gone anywhere. Those are the ones you hate as a receiver when it hits the top of the net and you're there watching it and it dribbles over on your side. Line block signalled against Van Aerssel, going after the ball against Meppelink. It's Van Aerssel they're looking to stop, but they can't. Nice from Clancy. She's playing absolutely magnificently, is Deliqua Clancy in this game. Almost a flawless performance, just the odd blip here and there. Yeah, she is doing really well, keeping this pressure on the Netherlands. That will relieve some of the pressure for Marleen and for Madeline. Good dig. Well, the line roll was on. Decides to go hard. This time it's put away by Madeline Meppelink. And the decision to change her serve paid dividends, didn't it? Marleen Van Aerssel deciding to go with a deep jump float serve. And then she makes the dig. Can't put it away first time. However, it's put away comfortably by Madeline Meppelink. Netherlands just one behind. Whistle goes. 5 seconds allowed once the whistle goes for serving on the beach. And again, that ball over on two, doing all the damage. Australia siding out, re-establishing their a two-point margin. Good chase from Clancy. Chase is on. Oh, that's a shame again. The Netherlands make a dig, but the other player can't go after the ball because the digger is in her way. happened in the first set, it's happened again here in the decider. Nice pick up from Meppelink, but Van Aerssel is tripped up and she tries to get past her. A shame for the Netherlands. Nice piece of luck for Australia as the ball wraps the top of the net and lands on the sand right in front of the Dutch duo. There's nothing you can do about that. A respite for the Netherlands, but they need some points and they need them now. This one only goes to 15 in the decider. Well, that's one of them, and that's the way to get it as well. Good hustle indeed from Van Aerssel. She read it perfectly. They're waiting for it. And then fixed the cross court, rolled the line, and the Netherlands take the point. They are on the comeback trail. Well, they decided just to go after Clancy. They know she's hitting, but at least it gives her time to get to the net and it gives her time to make the block. Oh, that was an opportunity for Van Aerssel. It was only a roll cross court, it was only a metre away from her. But she didn't back herself to go after it. Clever little pokey. Little collision at the net between Borden and Van Aerssel, and Borden apologises, and she came under the net. Great work from Marley. Well, they still need another point from serve just to draw level. Chance then. But it's not taken, it doesn't find the sideline, agonisingly wide for the Netherlands and the fans. And a sigh of relief for Australia. Borden gets away with it. Borden with the serve. Ooh, that might have been going long. Meppelink has to play it. But she puts it in exactly the right place, deep down the middle. And Borden thought Tilikwa was going to play it. And that's why there was hesitation. The Netherlands get their side out. They are still trailing, though. They are still having to force the issue. And it was that little reach from Clancy that put Borden off. This is a big serve. This is a huge moment for the Netherlands in the context of this match. Oh no! What a time to send one long. It's match point now for Australia. Oh, what a cruel blow for the Netherlands. Line block signalled against Meppelink. And the wide palm probably meaning just going after the ball against Van Aerssel. Clancy with the serve. It's picked up. Clancy for the match for Australia. And she's done it. The number one seeds have been knocked out. And it is Australia who are through to the quarterfinals. Nat Cook, the former Olympic gold medalist from Sydney, congratulating and applauding up in the crowd. Her girls have done it. Heartache for the Netherlands, as it's the end of the road for them. Wow, what a performance from Australia. They've silenced the crowd here. Head coach Morfose applauding the victory. Well, that was a tough one, wasn't it, for the Netherlands? A tough one to take when they look back on it as well. They had chances, they just couldn't convert when they put the ball into transition. And they couldn't quite deal with what Taliqua Clancy had to offer when she kept going over on two. Wow. Dreamland for Australia. Heartache for the Netherlands. This is how it was done. Van Aerssel had the swing to stay in, but rolling it comfortably to where Taliqua, goodness me, I'll stop saying that, could roll it off the block and out of play. And Australia are through to the quarterfinals. Magnificent result.